Well, thank you so much. Thank you for being here tonight to celebrate a night of jazz performance. And it looks like the weather is turning out pretty nice, very cooperative for a change. So we appreciate that too. All right, you just heard from two outstanding soloists on the tenor saxophone. You heard from Abby Yarbrough. First of all, let's give it up for Abby. The first tune was a tune called Doxy, written by the great Sonny Rollins, who I want to say is about 90 years old and still gigging in New York, and just a true icon. There's not many of those original icons still playing, you know, the Miles Davises, the John Coltranes, the Cannonball Adderleys, the Charlie Parkers, but he's one of them for sure. If you ever get a chance, check out his album called The Bridge. I think you'll really enjoy it. All right, so our next tune, we're going to change the style, and it's called Nice and Easy, and this is what we call the bossa nova. And the bossa nova was brought to the United States by Stan Getz, great tenor saxophone player, Gilberto Gervin, and then we had Charlie Bird, the great guitarist, and they brought this style called the bossa nova, and we're going to try to emulate that as well tonight. Mr. Owen Miller on the trumpet on the upper left corner. And the Hanson on the alto saxophone in the front row. And we understand she will see that face. Give her some more applause. She did it. She did it. Okay. Speaking of Annie Hanson, you're going to get to hear on this next number. You've heard this piece, so many movies, so many commercials, so many recordings of it. It's a pretty famous song, When I Fall in Love. And we're going to feature two solos. So you're going to hear from Abby towards the beginning on this beautiful ballad, and then also again from Ellison in the trombone section, When I Fall in Love, a ballad.
Thank you.
Abby and Ellison, one more time. Nice job, nice job. All right, so Jazz 2, we're getting ready along with everybody else. We have about, I don't know, 14 large groups playing on Saturday. We have multiple woodwind choirs, brass ensembles, percussion, large groups, small group, trios, quartets, quintets, octets, septets. We also have Jazz Combo, which you're going to hear after this group. We have Jazz Ensemble 2, and we have Jazz 1. I'm really proud of all these groups. The essence of what we're doing, in my opinion, is try to really learn. Jazz is America's art form. You know, it's passed by Congress, I think it was in 1981. Jazz was announced America's art form. So we're trying to learn that oral tradition along with the written word. And I think these students are doing a great job. You know, we're trying to go from just looking at notes on a page to playing the style. So we talk about who to listen to, Duke Ellington, Count Basie, the people I mentioned, Sonny Rollins, and they're doing such a great job. This next piece, this last piece that they're going to play tonight, we're going to play two songs on Saturday for solo ensemble. We get to play two, and one of the pieces has to be on the contest list. This piece happens to be on that along with the last piece you heard, and also Doxy. So this was written by, this piece is called Cute, and this really features one of our many outstanding percussionists that we have in this band program. You just heard from one previously, Max Meisner on the drums, who did a great job on that ballad. And now we're going to hear from Evan Sturken on this drum feature, where he's going to hold them up so the audience can see. He's playing with brushes, not the same brush maybe used on his hair, but a different kind of brush. The great Buddy Rich kind of made this style very famous, along with Gene Krupa. And this is written by the great Neil Hefti, who wrote for the Count Basie Big Band. We hope you enjoy Jazz 2 and Cute, and then we'll bring up our Jazz Combo before Jazz 1 plays. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much, Jennifer Sambatini. We hope you can come join us on Saturday if you're running for Senate in action. Like I said, they'll play two selections for that. And we'll talk a little bit about when you're really going to get to see them at the end of the year in just a second. So Jazz 2, let's do this. Let's make our way down the stairs there, and you can have a seat right in these first couple rows. And we're going to support Jazz Combo. Jazz Combo can make their way out and start getting set up. As Combo's come out, I'll tell you a little bit. I hope on the way in, I sent it out, but also on the way in, did the QR code work? Oh gosh, it's the first time I've ever done it. I can barely, turn the computer on. But anyway, I'm glad it worked out. So in there, take a look, and you can do this right now if you have your device while Jazz Combo is coming out to the stage. There's a QR code for the Jazz Dance, which I'm going to do this by memory. It should be Friday, May 12th at the Chandelier Ballroom from 6 till 10 p.m. And last year was our first year in Oconomowoc history doing it there. And I thought it went pretty darn well. I think we had near 600 people, something like that. This year we're going to have 1,200 people. Sure, the fire department's going to come. But yeah, we're going to buy them food and other things, and hopefully they won't turn their cheek. No, but anyway, we want you to come on out. If you don't know about what I'm talking about, it's what I would call an intergenerational event. So whether you're 116, or you're 16 months, or you're 16 years old, or whatever, there's dancing, there's incredible food, there's incredible raffle prizes, silent auction, dance competitions, high sea fruit punch, and other things like that. But it's a great event. And what's neat, I came from a place where we started an event like that 18, 20 years ago, and started off with 200 people. And then it was 250, and the next year was 400, and then 600. And last year we got it to 900 people, 930 people came. I'd like to see that this year. Let's get at least another 200 people. So spread the word, come and check it out. And if you're interested in donating a raffle or a silent auction, I know you can do that through that QR code. Okay, and you can also reach out to me here at Oconomowoc High School. All right, looks like we've got a combo ready to go. Why don't you folks get tuned, blow a couple notes, get warmed up, and then we'll tune. They're going to play three selections for you, and we'll talk about that in just a second. Thank you so much. So, you're probably wondering, who is the super senior on the bass? This young man is earning his GED currently at OHS. Too funny. So, I gotta tell you, education is fun, and sometimes it can be a little stressful when your bass player comes up to you less than a week before the concert and says, "I forgot, Mr. Gillette, I'm gonna be gone in Florida for the concert." But we've been talking about this for a while. And so, about 24 hours to find a bass player. And I thought, how lucky are we? We've got a great parent, great community member, incredible bass player who's traveling the country in a professional blues band, award-winning bass player, and who by day is an engineer, right? Am I correct? IT engineer, doctor, lawyer, teacher, all those things. But Mark Salveson took the call. He said, absolutely, I'll be there. And I said, we can pay you with Ocon school lunches. And he said, Sign me up. So, Mark Salveson, let's give it up for Mark for helping us out. Appreciate it very much, sir. Now, welcome to children. We're going to play a tune by the famous Dizzy Gillespie. We played a different arrangement of this, but this one is new on the contest list. Dizzy Gillespie, great trumpet player, the guy who played when his cheeks would come way out, if you remember him back in the days on the Muppet Show. That's where you might know him most. But Tunisia, you're going to hear two solos on this one. You're going to hear from Owen Miller, if my memory serves me correctly, and the famous Peyton Treble on the piano. So, A Night in Tunisia. Everybody, thank you. Thank you. Isn't that a fun one? What's neat about it goes between that Latin feel. Jump, 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 and it goes swing, two, three, four. So it kind of juxtaposes two different styles, if you will. So nice job in that rhythm section. How about our soloists again? So we heard from Owen on the trumpet solo and Peyton on the piano. So excellent job. Excellent job. I think it's always kind of fun to educate the audience. If you've never taken a solo or you don't listen to jazz, you may not know what they did. I talked about this at the Chili Feed. They're looking at these chord symbols, A minor, D7, G major, half diminished. And so there's symbols. And with those symbols, they need to know, I flat the third, I flat the seventh, I raise the fifth. It's like taking a jigsaw puzzle and putting it together quickly. And they're playing from their brain, but they're playing from their heart, they're playing from their soul. And that's what's so beautiful about jazz. And a lot of people don't get into it because it's pretty cerebral. You know, a lot of people like to live in the middle of the radio dial. And that's fine, but jazz is left corner, right corner. So this is kind of classical. All right, so very cool. We're going to play a tune written by the great Herbie Hancock, the great jazz pianist, who also you might have known from 1984. He wrote some funky rap music as well. He's a guy that covered many styles. He also won Album of the Year about 7 years ago for a hip-hop rock album. Played with the great Miles Davis, but he wrote this tune called Chameleon, and I want to know who's feeling it tonight. Who would like to take a solo when we get to measure 49? Who would like to go for it? All right, Lily, this is the neat democratic process where anybody who says, I want to do it, you get to do it. It's free for all. So Lily's feeling it. Who else feels like taking a solo tonight? Anybody else? No, it's got to be more than Lily. All right, we can't leave Lily out to dry. I think Payne's feeling it too. You know what I think we need to hear from? I think we need a bass solo as well. So let's do this. Let's go. We're going to go tenor, piano, bass, and then we're going to head back to the DS. All right, Chameleon. Thank you. Mark Solomon on the bass, everybody. Johnson on the tenor saxophone solo, was fantastic. Tim Trebo again on the piano. Mark Solomon on the bass. And how about Jackson in the impromptu drum solo? Jackson Meiser on the drum solo. All right, we've got one more for you entitled Dat Dare. And this was made famous by a great cornetist and an alto player. They're brothers, the Adderley brothers, Cannonball and Ned Adderley. Cannonball Adderley was probably my greatest inspiration. Around the time I was 9 years old, maybe 10, my father would come home with jazz albums. But my father would actually take me to these jazz clubs when I was 7, 8, 9 years old. My father was a writer and a poet, and he would perform poetry slam. He started the poetry slam movement in Chicago in 1980. He'd take me to these clubs. And I'd come home as an 8-year-old and be like, hey, do you have that on a record? He said, yeah, learn it. Listen to the record and play it. And so Cannonball Adderley was probably the reason why I think I became a music educator, to be honest, because he was so inspirational. So this tune called Dat Dare, inspired by the great Cannonball Adderley. We hope you enjoy it. This is our last tune with the combo, and then we're gonna bring jazz one. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
jazz combo, everyone. Jazz combo. Mason Carr on the alto saxophone solo. We can bring up Jazz Ensemble 1. Come on up and get comfy. Let these folks cool off their chops a little bit, and we'll get started. So make your way to the stage. We'll get a couple more announcements. If you are available, like we talked about, it's free to the public, and it's cool because we have, you know, 200 events or so going on all day from 8 a.m. to about 4 p.m. on Saturday. So again, if you want to hear a beautiful Gabrielli brass choir, if you want to hear a wonderful woodwind quintet, if you want to hear a sax quartet, a flute choir, clarinet, you name it, French horn octet, you can come and check it out. We'd love for you to come see what these wonderful students are doing. It's pretty magnificent. And then we have another concert right here coming up on Tuesday, March 14th, and that will feature a wonderful concert band under the direction of Mr. Henkel, and then symphonic band, and then a wind symphony. And each of the groups are playing something really fun. And then that'll get done at about 8:30, and at 3 in the morning, a number of us will be here to leave for New York City with the choir. And it's pretty spectacular. So it's really cool. And one thing I will take this moment to say, this is incredible. This is not everywhere. You don't have a space like this, and we appreciate, I know Sean Flater is back there along with the wonderful student crew and staff. We appreciate all you do to get us ready. So let's, you know, in the back right here, I can barely see that. Sean, if you could stand up, Eric can see you. And the rest of the crew, we appreciate it because this could not be possible without all their great work, and also John Kramer. So thank you for that. I know that currently we don't have enough room. Our band program, I haven't announced this to everyone yet, but our numbers have grown 23% next year. So we are at over 175 students, which is phenomenal. But we can't fit the band in the room, and there is no orchestra room. Our orchestra has grown and leaps and bounds. And so we're hoping that in the future there may be a space where we can rehearse all those kids in one place. So that's, you have an opportunity to read more about that, learn about the facilities for April 4th. Okay. So we've got Jazz One here. Why don't you folks blow a couple notes, long tones. I'll cut you off. We'll get a tuning note, and we will start off with a little Horace Silver. Go ahead. Blow a couple notes, everyone. Jazz One Time. So this first tune, we started working on it. We played it at the Chili dinner, but we had really only read it twice, which is fun to do. This is a tune by the great jazz pianist Horace Silver, and it's a blues. It's an F blues. Now, blues can be in all 12 keys. But this is in the key of F, and it's going to feature, in the alto saxophone, Mason Parr. It's going to feature Owen Miller again on the trumpet, and then it's going to feature the other part of a quartet of the Miller Girls. You're going to hear from Lucas Miller on the trombone as well. And if the name of this tune is called Filthy McNasty, and it's named after the percussion section. Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
All right, so how about that solo? Mason Tarr, sounds like Cannonball Adderley on that alto solo. Awesome job. Oh, another once again on the trumpet, Lucas Miller on the trombone. All right, now, Lucas Miller. All right, we're going to play a tune that we've been developing. It's very different than any other kind of jazz tune because it's like a tone poem. It paints a picture rather than swinging or Latin or a ballad. I think you'll get the idea once you hear it. But what's neat about this piece, number one, it was written by an Oconomowoc native, again, Fred Stern. So maybe some of you knew of Fred or knew his family that lived here for many years. Fred was one of the nation's greatest jazz educators, and he taught at Lawrence University for many years, and then he got the call from an even bigger school, the Eastman School of Music in Rochester, New York, and he taught there for about 9 or 10 years, I believe. And then he decided home is where the heart is, and came back to Lawrence University, and he passed away a few years ago of cancer. I had the chance to meet Fred Stern a number of times, and he's always a true gentleman, great educator, great writer. And this piece will feature on a different instrument you haven't heard tonight, the soprano saxophone. Mason is playing the soprano. It's in the key of B-flat. A lot of people, they see that and they think of one musician. Who do they think of when the soprano? Kenny G. I want you to think of some other people. And I like Kenny G, he's great. He's really good. But Kenny G, what he did, he mastered the very syrupy ballads, which are great. But John Coltrane and Steve Lacy are the people that would take this instrument, just take it to another level. So you're gonna hear from that, and you're also gonna hear a wonderful piano solo from Peyton on the piano, where he's gonna play very ethereal. And so we hope you enjoy this Riverscape.
There we go.
Mason Carlisle, thank you for those beautiful souls. That was fantastic. Wonderful, wonderful. All right, now, this is a lot of fun. So I got to take a piece that we did on an album. Well, back then it was almost an album. I guess it was on a CD, but University of Wisconsin, Eau Claire, where I attended. It was a pretty special place. My junior year, we received the top college jazz band in the United States award by Downbeat magazine, and this song was one of the songs on there called Pleasin', and it was written by the great Sammy Nestico. Earlier, I talked about the tune Cute that Evan Sturkin was featured on, Neil Hefti. Well, the other person that wrote for Count Basie was Sammy Nestico. And if any of you played in a high school or middle school jazz band, I can guarantee that you played some of his music. So this is called Pleasin', and it's just like a beautiful, slow swing, which is hard to do when you're young. Because when you're young, you want to do everything fast. And so we're trying to age these people. I said, pretend you're 80, you're retired. The 401k, the 403b, the 529, it's all looking good. So we're going to slow it down. Here we go. Peyton's going to play a beautiful solo on this one. Thank you. again, Kate, just beautiful. You told the story of a guy that's much older than 18 or 17. How old are you, 17?
18.
Well, just yesterday you were 17. Speaking of that, that's a great segue. Folks, get your warm up. Miami, Miami, Miami. All right. I know there's a special someone in here who's done a heck of a lot for this band program for many years. And I found out maybe a little birdie named Kurt told me yesterday. So we are very fortunate. The students are fortunate. The community is fortunate. I am fortunate as a teacher. We have great parents here, as good as they come anywhere. And I can't thank all the people that do the behind-the-scenes work, like put on this great jazz dance that we're doing in May 12th. Carrie, you've blown me away. You've turned this into a full-time job without any pay, extrinsically. So we need to celebrate you. Where are you, Carrie? Are you here tonight? Did you come to hear your wonderful daughter, Sarah? Okay. All right, so let's sing Happy Birthday, our best band voices. Happy Birthday to Carrie Downs, everybody. Here we go, let's try it out. She turned 41 years in the cup. Yeah. 1, 2. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Carrie. Happy birthday to you. And many more. All right, happy birthday. Awesome. All right, now, we're going to end this in a funky fashion. This is cool. When you have a band as good as these kiddos, you say, hey, let's put this together in maybe three reads. It's called Honk, and it's going to feature. Stand up, Ty, come on. Everyone needs to see you. This guy, to the outsider, he seems like a quiet, shy, demure man, but he's got this alter ego, I'm finding out. And it's what's amazing, almost every day in class, he and I are wearing the same thing. So I think I'm just trying to just hit this tie, but listen to him, hold down the fort, and then his main man, Ronan, behind him, is going to try to match that intensity on the bass bone. All right, you're going to try to match him. Yeah, he's like, I don't even read music. No, I'm just kidding. All right, now, so we're going to play one more. It's called Haunt by Jeff Jarvis. And everyone, we'll see who's feeling the solos. You look at me, and we'll go for it. Lucas is going to take the first one. And afterwards, Jazz 2, Jazz 1, you're cordially required to stack all the music stands, the chairs, because otherwise Sean back there is going to slash my car tires. So we're gonna load these stands and chairs back here. We're going to unplug the lights. We're going to wrap them up. We're going to put them neatly in the back. We're going to help percussion. In 10 minutes, this place is going to look like we were never here. Okay, other than all the gum stuck under the chairs. Just kidding. No, we didn't do that. All right, so here we go. Thanks for being here tonight. Honk. And we hope to see you Saturday at Solo Ensemble and March 14th and May 12th and all the other parades we're doing. Jordan Haney, everybody. Jordan Haney. Congratulations. Once again, for Jazz Ensemble 2, let's give it up for them. And Jazz Cowboy, thank you. Thank you for coming along and supporting the arts. Thank you for supporting this beautiful facility. And like I said, we hope to see you at these upcoming events this Saturday, March 14th, the Memorial Day Parade, graduation, and of course the big jazz dance on Friday, May 12th at the Chandelier Ballroom. Hope to see you in Hartford. Thank you all. Jazz 2, if you'd be willing to maybe just lightly set your instruments here carefully, and then we'll load up chairs, stands, wrapped lights, and help percussion. Have a great night, everybody. Thanks for being here. Thank you.